going to go ahead and talk a little bit now, since it's difficult to put all of the information in text format on the screen. But as mentioned, Carob is a female Syrian, and she's about 8 months old. Now, her story actually isn't as complicated as some of my past adoptions, and I don't know a whole lot about her either, but I do know that her previous family was moving, and they had to drop her off at the shelter. I'm not exactly sure the situation, so I don't want to judge, but I do believe they cared enough about her to at least bring her to a shelter where she would be taken care of, and she wasn't like just abandoned or anything like that. I remember when I adopted Sumatra that he actually was just abandoned in the house and left there, and somebody had found him, and I think that's really sad. So at least Carob's situation was slightly different in that sense. So I had seen her ad for about 1.5 or 2 days, I believe it was, before I had decided to go in and take a look at her. And I told my mom, and it's so funny because my mom is very encouraging of me adopting hamsters, and she's always like, oh, you know, you need the hamster and the hamster needs you and you'll give it such a good home and stuff. So she automatically was very encouraging, and she went with me to the shelter. I wanted to just go to check out the hamster, and of course every time I do that I always fall in love immediately. So I did fall in love with Carob, and she was so cute. Now we went, it was about a half an hour before the shelter closed, so I didn't have a whole lot of time, but I decided to go back the next day to adopt her because I wanted to just think about it a little bit, and also I had to clean out Ginger Snap's cage because I hadn't even done that yet. I wasn't like necessarily looking to adopt a hamster. I mean, obviously I was looking, but I wasn't like in a rush or anything like that, so I hadn't cleaned his cage out. So when we went back the next day, I did end up taking her out and holding her a little bit. Now, she was about half asleep, so she basically just sat there in my hand and didn't seem super active, and it reminded me a lot of Sumatra when I had gone in to look at him. He just sat in my lap, and I was like, oh, she's, you know, so calm. So I filled out the adoption paperwork and took her home and had a lot of fun watching her explore the cage. She was really energetic, checking everything all out. So she does seem fairly social in the sense that she will sort of get excited when you walk in the room, and you know, she'll expect food and stuff like that. But she's actually not as tame as I had got the impression initially, as far as her climbing onto my hands and stuff like that. She's actually very jumpy, and I have to hold her very low on soft carpet, so that way when she does jump out like she has before, she's not going to hurt herself. So we are definitely going to be working on that, and I'd like to, you know, get her to relax a little bit. I'm not worried about it. I remember Yodel actually was the exact same way. He was very jumpy, and he ended up being the hamster that I trusted the most to just walk around with, and he would just sort of chill, so I have no doubt that Carob will come around eventually. So I believe that she originally was living in a critter trail cage, based on the picture I had seen of her. So the cage that she is in now, she has about 8 times more space, and she is really enjoying it. I just can't imagine her being in any cage that's smaller than what she has, because she is really active at night, and it's so much fun to watch her running all around. She seems the type of hamster that's going to get bored quickly with the same setup, so I'm probably going to have to give her new toys about maybe every week or two, but we'll see how that goes. Now, as far as taming, I know a lot of people ask me, they're like, can you please record your hamster when you're taming and, you know, show what you do and stuff like that. It's actually not any particular thing that I do so much as a bunch of little things all put together, if that makes sense. So say for example I might walk in the room and I will talk to her. I'm trying to get her used to my voice and associating my voice with good things, like I give her a little treat or I might say hi to her or something like that, and then other times I will take her out, but it's just little things that I do, and I don't always have the camera you know, ready. It's not like I plan, okay, now we're going to tame and I'm going to take you out, Carob, and you're going to do this. And it's not quite that way when you tame hamsters. It's just, you sort of, I don't know, I guess I sort of go by their behavior and how ready that they are, if that makes any sense at all. Another thing is I tend to enjoy personal time with them sometimes. I don't always want to have the camera in my hand, you know, filming for YouTube. Like, I like to just have personal, special time with them that nobody else sees, and I don't have to sit there and try to hold them and hold the camera, which is really hard, especially since she's very jumpy. So hopefully you guys can understand that, but I'm hoping that she will show progress as the videos go on, that, you know, I will be able to hold her and hopefully film at the same time, but we'll see how that goes. I think this is long enough for now. I'm trying to think if there's anything else I forgot to cover, but hopefully this answers a lot of your questions. You'll definitely see a lot more of her in future. She does seem comfortable enough to come out and have me film videos with and stuff like that, so that's nice. So up next, I'm thinking I'm going to do Dumpling's Christmas cage tour, and then I will be doing a cage tour for Carob. What she has right now is actually just temporary. Whenever I adopt hamsters, I prefer to just use mostly plastic and ceramic toys at first, just in case there'd be any issue with, like, mites or, you know, something that would get passed on. I don't want to have to throw all of my wood toys out. So I just put her for a couple of weeks with plastic and ceramic, and she is going to be getting some wood toys next. Now, she has been checked out by a vet and she was deemed healthy, so that's good to know. I'm obviously keeping an eye on her to see my own judgment and... okay, I'm totally losing my train of thought here. Sorry, guys, it's pretty late. But anyway, I'm watching her to see if there's anything that sticks out to me or concerns me. But so far, she does seem very healthy, so that's good. So I'm going to end this here for tonight since I'm getting too tired to talk. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye!